I'm the private eye of this city. It's my job to watch from the shadows, sniff out the lies, and shine light on the truth. But this latest case got me more puzzled than a book of Sudokus. Red Drinko says that on average, people drink their cans of soda more than any other. But Blue Drink Group and Green Drink Limited are saying exactly the same thing. I gotta get to the bottom of this, but I can't do it alone. Dr. Tom, meet me at the speakeasy in 10 minutes. The password? Statistics. So, like I tells you...
Will, can you stop talking like that?
Sorry. So, like I said, I'm really confused how three different drinks companies can all say that, on average, people drink their product the most. That's just not possible. Two of them must be telling lies.
Well, it is in fact possible that they're all telling the truth if they're all using a different way of calculating the average. Meet the three suspects: mean, mode, and median.
Perfect. We're gonna crack this case in no time.
Seriously, stop doing that voice.
Before we start solving the mystery, what does average actually mean?
Well, the average value of a dataset is a single value that represents the dataset as a whole. It can help us to quickly get a general idea about lots of data without having to understand each individual value in the set.
Okay, so it's how the drinks companies can turn their research data into easy-to-read headlines.
Exactly. Here are three different ways of calculating the average value in a dataset: mean, mode, and median. Mean is the most common type of average. It's calculated by adding up all the data and dividing it by the number of values there are. So for this data set, we do 7 plus 1 plus 7 plus 0 plus 7 plus 5 plus 1, which equals 28. Then, because there are 7 values in total, we divide 28 by 7, which gives us a mean of 4. Mode is the value that occurs the most. For this data set, 7 turns up 3 times, 1 turns up twice, 0 turns up once, and 5 turns up once. 7 turns up the most, so that means the mode is 7. Median is the value in the middle. To find out the median, we first have to put the data in order. Then we see which value is in the middle position of the data set. We can easily do that by counting inwards from both sides until we find the middle. That means the median here is 5. If you have an even number of values, you count inwards from both sides to find the 2 values in the middle. Then you add them together and divide the total by 2. So here, the 2 values in the middle are 1 and 5, so we do 1 plus 5, which equals 6. Then we divide 6 by 2, which gives us a median of 3.
Okay, so we've got the mean, the mode, and the median. And with the exact same data, we can get 3 different average values just by using different ways of calculating it. That's why the drinks companies might not be lying. I think we're ready to start getting to the bottom of this case.
Okay, so Red Drink Co., Blue Drink Group, and Green Drink Limited all say that on average, people drink their product the most. They all asked different age groups how many cans they drank every week. Let's start by looking at the data from Red Drink Co.
So according to Red Drink Co., people aged 20 to 29 said they drank 9 cans a week. 30 to 39 said 4 cans. 40 to 49 said 6 cans. 50 to 59 said 4 cans. And 60 plus said 5 cans.
Okay, so let's start by calculating the mean average. To work out the mean, we add up all the data and divide it by the number of values there are. So here, we do 9 plus 4 plus 6 plus 4 plus 5, which equals 28. Then, because there are 5 values in total, we divide 28 by 5, which gives us a mean of 5.6.
Great, let's work out the mode next.
So the mode, remember, is the value that occurs the most. In this case, 9 turns up once, 4 turns up twice, 6 turns up once, and 5 turns up once. 4 turns up the most, so that means the mode is 4.
Awesome. So the last average to work out is the median.
So the median is the value in the middle. To find out the median, we first have to put the data in order. Then we see which value is in the middle of the data set. Let's do that by counting inwards from both sides until we find the middle. And there it is. That means the median is 5.
So the mean amount of red drink that people have a week is 5.6 cans. The mode amount is 4 cans, and the median is 5 cans. 1 down, 2 to go.
Now let's move on to blue drink group.
So according to blue drink group, people aged 20 to 29 said they drank 6 cans a week. 30 to 39 said 15 cans. 40 to 49 said 6 cans. 50 to 59 said 5 cans. And 60 plus said 4 cans.
Okay, so let's start by calculating the mean average. To work out the mean, we add up all the data and divide it by the number of values there are. So we do 6 plus 15 plus 6 plus 5 plus 4, which equals 36. Then, because there are 5 values in total, we divide 36 by 5, which gives a mean of 7.2.
Okay, let's work out the mode next.
Great. So the mode, remember, is the value that occurs the most. In this case, 6 turns up twice, 15 turns up once, 5 turns up once, and 4 turns up once. 6 turns up the most, and so 6 is the mode.
Brilliant. So the last average to work out is the median.
As before, the median is the value in the middle. To find out the median, we first have to put the data in order. Then we see which value is in the middle of the data set. Let's do that by counting inwards from both sides until we find the middle. And there it is. The median here is 6.
So the mean amount of blue drink that people have a week is 7.2 cans. The mode amount is 6 cans, and the median is 6 cans as well. Just one more left.
The final suspect is Green Drink Limited.
So according to Green Drink Limited, people aged 20 to 29 said they drank 3 cans a week. 30 to 39 said 2 cans. 40 to 49 said 7 cans. 50 to 59 said 7 cans. And 60 plus said 0 cans.
Once again, let's start by calculating the mean average. Just like before, we add up all the data and divide the total by the number of values there are. So here we do 3 plus 2 plus 7 plus 7 plus 0, which equals 19. Then, because there are 5 values in total, we divide 19 by 5, which gives us a mean of 3.8.
Okay, let's work out the mode next.
Again, the mode is the value that occurs the most. In this case, 3 turns up once, 2 turns up once, 7 turns up twice, and 0 turns up once. 7 turns up the most, and so 7 is the mode.
Excellent. So the last average to work out is the median.
The median is the value in the middle. And remember, to find out the median, we first have to put the data in order. Then we see which value is in the middle of the data set. Let's do that by counting inwards from both sides until we find the middle position. And there it is. The median here is 3.
So the mean amount of green drink that people have a week is 3.8 cans. The mode amount is 7 cans, and the median is 3 cans. We have all the information we need to crack the case. Okay, so let's solve the mystery once and for all. Red Drink Co., Blue Drink Group, and Green Drink Limited all say that, on average, people have more cans of their drink a week than any other. Who's telling the truth?
Let's find out. Here are the mean, mode, and median values for the cans of red drink, blue drink, and green drink that people have every week. The mean amount of red drink is 5.6 cans, the mean amount of blue drink is 7.2 cans, and the mean amount of green drink is 3.8 cans.
So Blue Drink Group is the winner for the mean.
The mode amount of red drink is 4 cans, the mode amount of blue drink is 6 cans, and the mode amount of green drink is 7 cans.
So Green Drink Limited has the highest mode.
The median amount of red drink is 5 cans, the median amount of blue drink is 6 cans, and the median amount of green drink is 3 cans.
So Blue Drink Group comes out on top for the median.
If Blue Drink Group had the highest mean and median average, and Green Drink Limited had the highest mode average, do you know what that means?
It means that Red Drinko were fleecing us all along. It's time to pull the plug on those sneaky chumps. And just like that, this case is closed. Okay, so I'm going to quickly remind myself. The mean is calculated by adding up all the data and dividing it by the number of values there are. The mode is the value that occurs the most, and the median is the value in the middle.
Right, let's play a game. A brand new case has just come in. Pink Crisps Corp, Orange Crisps PLC, and Purple Crisps Inc. are all saying that, on average, people eat more bags of their crisps a week than any other. I want you to calculate the averages for each one and work out if any of them are telling lies. Here's the data for Pink Crisps Corp. They say that people aged 20 to 29 said they ate 12 bags a week, 30 to 39 said 3 bags, 40 to 49 said 6 bags, 50 to 59 said 10 bags, and 60 plus said 3 bags. What are the mean, mode, and median values? If you want, you can pause the video and do it all by yourself, or keep watching to hear Will's answers.
Okay, so let's start by calculating the mean average. To work out the mean, we add up all the data and divide it by the number of values there are. So we do 12 plus 3 plus 6 plus 10 plus 3. Which equals 34. Then, because there are 5 values in total, we divide 34 by 5, which gives us a mean of 6.8. Let's work out the mode next, which is the value that occurs the most. In this case, 12 turns up once, 3 turns up twice, 6 turns up once, and 10 turns up once. 3 turns up the most, so that means the mode is 3. The last average to work out is the median, which is the value in the middle. To find out the median, we first have to put the data in order. Then, we see which value is in the middle of the data set. I'll do that by counting inwards from both sides until we find the middle. There it is! That means the median is 6. So for Pink Crisps Corp, the mean is 6.8, the mode is 3, and the median is 6.
Great! Here's the data for Orange Crisps PLC. They say that people aged 20 to 29 ate 3 bags a week, 30 to 39 said they ate 17 bags, 40 to 49 said 6 bags, 50 to 59 said 3 bags, and 60 plus said 2 bags. What are the mean, mode, and median values?
Okay, so let's start by calculating the mean average. To work out the mean, we add up all the data and divide it by the number of values there are. So we do 3 plus 17 plus 6 plus 3 plus 2, which equals 31. Then, because there are 5 values in total, we divide 31 by 5, which gives us a mean of 6.2. Let's work out the mode next, which is the value that occurs the most. In this case, 3 turns up twice, 17 turns up once, 6 turns up once, and 2 turns up once. 3 turns up the most, so that means the mode is 3. The last average to work out is the median, which is the value in the middle. To find out the median, we first have to put the data in order. Then, we see which value is in the middle of the data set. I'll do that by counting inwards from both sides until we find the middle. There it is! That means the median is 3. So for Orange Crisps PLC, the mean is 6.2, the mode is 3, and the median is 3.
Excellent! Finally, here's the data for Purple Crisps Inc. They say that people aged 20 to 29 said they ate 4 bags a week, 30 to 39 said 8 bags, 40 to 49 said 4 bags, 50 to 59 said 9 bags, and 60 plus says 0 bags. What are the mean, mode, and median values?
Okay, so let's start by calculating the mean average. To work out the mean, we add up all the data and divide it by the number of values there are. So we do 4 plus 8 plus 4 plus 9 plus 0, which equals 25. Then, because there are 5 values in total, we divide 25 by 5, which gives us a mean of 5. Let's work out the mode next, which is the value that occurs the most. In this case, 4 turns up twice, 8 turns up once, 9 turns up once, and 0 turns up once. 4 turns up the most, so that means the mode is 4. The last average to work out is the median, which is the value in the middle. To find out the median, we first have to put the data in order. Then, we see which value is in the middle of the dataset. I'll do that by counting inwards from both sides until we find the middle. There it is! That means the median is 4. So for Purple Crisps Inc, the mean is 5, the mode is 4, and the median is 4.
Awesome! We have all the information we need to crack the case. The mean amount of pink crisps is 6.8 bags, the mean amount of orange crisps is 6.2 bags, and the mean amount of purple crisps is 5 bags.
So Pink Crisps Corp is the winner for the mean.
The mode amount of pink crisps is 3 bags, the mode amount of orange crisps is 3 bags, and the mode amount of purple crisps is 4 bags.
So Purple Crisps Inc. has the highest mode.
The median amount of pink crisps is 6 bags, the median amount of orange crisps is 3 bags, and the median amount of purple crisps is 4 bags.
So Pink Crisps Corp comes out on top for the median. Pink Crisps Corp had the highest mean and median average, and Purple Crisps Inc. had the highest mode average. Orange Crisp PLC are a bunch of phony grifters. That's another case closed. Okay, so I'm going to quickly remind myself one more time. The mean is calculated by adding up all the data and dividing it by the number of values there are. The mode is the value that occurs the most, and the median is the value in the middle.
Looks like you've got it, Will. Statistics are used every single day to tell us how we should feel about something, but sometimes we need to do some detective work to really understand the data.
This city is built on a web of lies, a smokescreen disguising the truth. Reality is swept under the rug, but if you take a moment to look closer, you'll see what's really going on. Dr. Tom, I couldn't have cracked these cases without you. You've been a swell guy. If you want to keep practicing, download the worksheet in the video description. It's time for you to do a bit of detective work of your own. This magnifying glass is hiding somewhere in the video. Can you find it? Tell me where it is in the comments below. If you like this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to learn more science, English, and maths with Will, and let me know what you want to learn next by commenting below or emailing info@learnwithwill.co.uk.